Somerville, we finally reached the end of the year.
Yep, us seniors only got two more days left.
It's our senior show, and today is Friday, May 10th. I'm Ava Grafton.
And I'm Evan Glenn.
And Wave TV.
And Wave TV.
And Wave TV.
Wave TV.
And Wave TV
starts now.
What thing, like an arpeggio thing, like da-da-da-da-da, like, I don't know. Get like a little industrial thing going. And that doesn't change, we need to switch the strings up. Have this like going to like a little like.
Recent ban on TikTok has caused quite a commotion around the country.
Many people are concerned about the freedoms being taken away.
With more information, Stan Stanridge.
In March of last year, the House of Representatives passed a bill called PFACA, or Protecting Americans from Foreign Adversary Controlled Applications Act. And last Wednesday, this mouthful of a bill was signed into law by President Biden. A quick recap on this bill states that TikTok, used by over 1 billion people globally, would get permabanned in the U.S. unless ByteDance, the company that owns TikTok, sells the app. Why is this happening, you might ask? Well, it's because a court full of people well over the age of retirement believe that the Chinese Communist Party is stealing American users' data and sending it back to China. As if America doesn't have apps that steal your data already, like Facebook, for example.
Now, the Senate says that this bill is for the greater good of the country, but most people know that's just another way for them to gain more control over the U.S. economy. You might be thinking, Stan, isn't that in violation of the First Amendment? Yes. When it all comes down to it, though, the real question is, why should anyone care? It's just an app that you can watch silly videos on. Well, TikTok has been a key to success for many people in the U.S. They can promote their businesses, advertise products, or basically show off anything they want to, whether it be a small-owned business or restaurant, an artist trying to make it with their music, or even Trisha Paytas. Look.
It's gross. How would a ban like this even work? It's not like the government can just come up and uninstall TikTok from my phone while I'm watching Baby Gronk rears up Livy Gun or something.
Well, shut up and let me explain. Your phone wouldn't magically uninstall TikTok if you already have it, no. It would simply be removed from the App Store, preventing updates until eventually the app was unusable. Rickified, if you will. Until then, you can watch as many skibbity toilet clips as you want. Reporting for Wave TV, I'm Stan Sandridge.
For Teacher Appreciation Week, make sure to thank your teachers for everything they do.
This past week was Teacher Appreciation Week, a time to give the incredible teaching staff here at Somerville High School the attention and credit that they deserve. Today, we're walking the halls of Somerville High to see which teachers you appreciate the most. Who's your favorite teacher?
That's kind of hard. Miss Litz and Miss Hewlett, I love them.
Why are they your favorite teachers?
Because she helped me pass math, or I would have failed math.
I would say Coach Burkhart because he let me put flags in his classroom, and I love flags, so I gotta give him that.
Is there anything that you would like to say to Coach Burkhart?
I miss you, bro, please. I hate my new classes, please.
My favorite teacher is Miss Wetzel, and the thing I want to tell her is that I love you and I hope you get better.
My favorite teacher is Miss St. Andrews. She's pretty chill. She doesn't really do too much, and that's it for real.
Do you want to say anything to her?
I hope you're doing well, I guess.
Okay, who's your favorite teacher?
My favorite teacher, Ms. Meyer.
Why is Ms. Meyer your favorite teacher?
Because she actually cares about me and actually cares about what I do.
Dorigo.
Why?
And Mr. Jimenez.
Why?
Because they're homies.
Is there anything you'd like to say then?
Juice WRLD is better than every rapper ever.
Make sure to tell your favorite teacher how grateful you are for them today. Reporting for Wave TV, I'm Dominique Dawson.
Max Cheesewright has come up with the student spotlight.
Gina LaMattina is the star of the last spotlight for this year.
Hi, I'm Gino. I am part of track and cross country. I've been running it for the past 4 to 5 years now. I run the mile and 2 mile. This Saturday I'll be running the 2 mile. I'm hoping I can break 10:30, but we'll see. And I work as the engineering club co/vice president. So pretty much because I've been doing track, cross country, and band for years now, I can't really drive away from the school and come back to get a really good job. So the best job here is just working at the school with people. Like, I've visited all of the middle schools and everything. Everybody knows who I am now, just because I work here at the school. It's great.
You don't have to go anywhere, and then you just come down here for practice.
He's an engineering intern, so he's been put in the classroom to help with supplies and some instruction, and he encourages the students, and he worked really, really well with the trebuchet teams, because in years past he's built a trebuchet. This year he didn't get to be on a team, but he oversaw the two teams that we had, and just sort of kept the excitement and momentum going. So he was great at that.
Me and Gino and Ms. Tregesek all co-organized STEM Fest, and Gino, being the vice president of Engineering Club, was a massive help. He did so much for STEM Fest. Anything that I needed done, I would tell Gino I need this done, and it would be done. Gino just exemplifies in so many ways how somebody can be so passionate about something without having to be told, hey, Gino, you need to do this. He just does it. He has such integrity and such initiative, and I think people have so much to take inspiration from that, and I think that's just such an amazing part about Gino.
Of course, for the last show, we have to do one of our favorite segments.
That's right. Ava Grafton gives us another music report.
Hey, Somerville. It's not even halfway through 2024, and we've already got some great, noteworthy music to talk about. 21 Savage is the first artist up today with his new album, American Dream. With features from Doja Cat, Metro Boomin, Travis Scott, and others, American Dream leans into a more intimate view of the artist's life and career. Whoa, whoa. Want it all, I won't leave a breadcrumb. Sign's album, Vultures 1, drops the religious pretext surrounding West's previous two albums and returns to familiar themes like relationships, money, and fame. Vultures production was noted as being unique and cohesive with his style. This the Game of Thrones, easing out the clothes. Arianators, get ready, because our next album up today is Eternal Sunshine. Miss Grande's highly anticipated 7th studio album is referred to by the artist herself as a concept album, incorporating moments of emotional vulnerability and even referencing media critiques of her new relationship with Wicked co-star Ethan Slater. I don't wanna tiptoe, but I don't wanna hide, but I don't wanna feed this monster. After being rejected by the country music circuit, Beyoncé decided to dive deeper into the history of the genre and created Cowboy Carter. Beyoncé describes her new album as a reinvention of Americana and highlights the overlooked contributions of black artists to country music. Last, but certainly not least, the mastermind herself, Taylor Swift, released a double album, The Tortured Poets Department. It's described as one of minimalistic synth-pop production. While fans were expecting this new album to cover the breakup of Taylor Swift and Joe Alwyn, many were shocked to discover a good number of tracks allegedly about Maddie Healy. While we couldn't mention all the new albums, here are some honorable mentions. Lofty dropped Bewitched, the Goddess Edition. And her new single, Good Luck Babe, are taking over TikTok. Finally, Conan Gray dropped his latest album, Found Heaven. That's all the music we have for you this week. Reporting for Wave TV, I'm Ava Grafton.
While the teachers leave us with memories, we need to leave a little something for the underclassmen.
That's why Richard Wynn asked the class of 2024 what advice we should give to the next wave of students.
As the school year ends, our seniors will be moving on to college and leaving this wonderful school behind. But today, we're going to ask for some final words of wisdom from our upperclassmen and get some advice that might, hopefully, inspire the next generation. Do you have any advice for any rising seniors?
Just don't get lazy, or else it's going to hurt you whenever you try to get into college.
Get your money up, man. If you ain't got money, ain't nobody gonna like you. So, if you get a job, that's the same.
Make sure to get your work done. It's gonna hit you hard senior year.
I would say some advice would be to join some clubs, especially if you're struggling to make friends. I know that I struggle to make friends, and by joining clubs, I was able to get into social circles with like-minded people.
Honestly, if you need help with anything, feel free to, like, ask your teachers. Ain't nobody gonna judge you or nothing. Like, don't be shy. I know people are going to be like, oh yeah, man, you seem like a wimp, or like, just ask your teacher. That's what, it's their job. So just kind of, oh, hey, I don't understand this. Just ask. It ain't that deep, bro.
Get your confidence up as soon as you can. I know it's hard. I struggled with it. I don't know how to talk to people. I'm talking to someone right now. As long as you, the more you talk to people, the easier it gets. And yeah, just talk to more people, bro.
Thank you. For all of Somerville High School seniors, we thank you for your advice. Reporting for Wave TV, I'm Richard Wynn.
Focus on being a better you and not a better them. Don't worry about what others are doing. Worry about, you know, making yourself better, because they're going to worry about themselves as well.
It's an opportunity to start fresh.
Before you say or do anything, pause, wait, think. Give your brain a chance to catch up to keep you from doing or saying something that you shouldn't.
And be who it is that you really, really want to be.
Get involved in something and break out of kind of maybe the mold that you had in high school. And again, enjoy those years.
Always try to be considerate that somebody else might be having a bad day.
Life is 10% what happens to you and 90% how you react to it.
Every season is going to have challenges, but you know, just celebrate where you are.
Whenever you run into those troublesome times, you run into those hardships and you see that storm up ahead and you feel that heat coming from the fire, don't run from it.
Congratulations, seniors. You just completed the least challenging thing you probably ever will, with the most forgiveness and grace you'll probably ever get.
I would say be proud of this moment.
You worked really hard. You deserve it.
So God bless you, class of 2024. I wish you the best.
My advice for underclassmen is to always make sure you stay involved in the school.
That's about it for this year. After high school, I'm going to Trident Technical College, and I'm going to be majoring in film production. Signing off for the last time, I'm Daniel Morris.
After high school, I will be attending Trident Technical, and I will be majoring in film and production. Signing off for the last time, I'm Bray Buckner.
In the fall, I'll be attending Trident Tech to pursue education. Signing off for the last time, I'm Evan Glenn.
In the fall, I will be attending Lander University and majoring in history. Signing off for the last time, I'm Ava Grafton.
In the fall, I'll be attending the University of South Carolina, majoring in biochemistry. Signing off for the last time, I'm Kinsey Faircloth.
After high school, I hope to accomplish my goals and enter the workforce. Reporting for the last time, I'm Max Hedre.
After school, I'll be heading into the workforce and continuing working on music. Signing off for the last time, I'm Dagan Faith.
For the next few years, I'll be working on my own music and I'll probably move out of state. Signing off for the last time, I'm Tyler Sabian.
After high school, I will be going to the Savannah College of Art and Design and studying performing arts.
And after high school, I'll be going to Trident Tech, where I'll be majoring in U.S. history.
Signing off for the last time, I'm Adora Jarrett.
And I'm Austin Day. You stay classy, Somerville.